Good afternoon, everyone. Steve Georgia here from Allendale's Trading Floor. It's August 9th. We did have stronger trade today as we move into the USDA report tomorrow morning at 7:30. Corn ended up 7.5 higher today, making new all-time highs once again for corn, sitting at $8, just below $8.30. We did have beans finding some support today, rallying about 50 cents higher, with wheat up about 13. So I mentioned beans leading the way. Now, we did have another sale today, 160,000 bushel of corn to China. There was talks most of the day of another 2 to 3 cargoes of beans that China's looking to purchase. That's been rumored. Did not see that yet today. But still, that's showing that there is demand at these levels, and I think that's why you got this rally in the beans. Not only that, guys are expecting to see tighter ending stocks tomorrow for not only beans, but also corn. So with the beans, looking for quite a drop there yet again in the beans as we've continued to see the good to excellent ratings erode. Maybe we're going to see USDA move their yield down again, which will affect production numbers. Same thing with corn. We are looking for corn numbers about 660 million as far as carryout on that corn. But the thing with that and what we could see for both corn and beans, mostly corn, is how is USDA going to affect or move the demand side of things? What's going to happen here as far as ethanol? We know that's been slowing down. Feed and residual, well, that's been slowing down as well. And same thing here, with some of the other factors, export sales. We saw good export sales today for corn, but that's 1 week here. So we've got to continue to see that demand come in. But these are all things that USDA can shift, and they can move around as far as the demand figures. Beans, on the other hand, like we saw yesterday, today, good export sales. And then today with the export numbers they were looking for, 350 to 450, we got 300,000. You know, we have been exporting beans. But now China is back in the mix, and anytime we talk China, what happens? We see the market rally. So that demand side of things, I don't see the demand on beans, USDA moving that demand much. But we'll see. Those numbers come out at 7:30. We're going to see a lot of movement in this market tomorrow. We're probably not going to sit still. So we rallied going into it. We better see a bullish report to feed these bulls. Otherwise, we may see this market move sharply lower if that's not the case. We've seen a good rally up until this point. Outside markets that haven't mattered much, but the dollar up 28 cents today, crude oil up 17, not a lot of movement there. As far as livestock, fat cattle 10 cents higher today, 125.77. We've seen a good rally. We saw, as I mentioned yesterday, boxed beef very supportive once again. Choice up $1.19, select up 139. We did see some lighter trade here as far as address basis in Nebraska. But we've seen a good rally to this point. We should see more trade this week as far as cash cattle. You do have some guys holding out for higher prices yet. We'll see if we do get those, but that should affect price here in the short term. As far as the hogs, about 27 cents higher today in the October, 75.90. You got a few days left here with the August. August up 25 cents as well, 91.82. We've seen a good climb here and a good jump for that August contract. But as I mentioned, we've got up into next week with this, but the cash market's still hovering around 94. So with the cash market being higher than where we're currently at, you still have the futures trying to climb to that cash price. Or are we going to see cash break back down to these futures? So the longer it stays up at 94, the more supportive it is here in the near-term August contract. So continue watching that. I do suspect we could see some quieter trades tonight. So we open the grains again at 5 o'clock. I suspect we could see some quieter trades as guys had gotten in position here today and ready for that report tomorrow morning. One thing that we've been talking about for the last several months, and I haven't talked about yet today, is the weather. So after this report comes out and we get to see what's going on, what USDA puts out, we're going to go and focus back on the weather again. We've had some good rains move through the Midwest, certainly supporting or should be more negative on beans right now and should help the beans along, so negative on price, but still help the beans quite a bit that are out there, maybe looking at a little better yields yet. But there's still a lot of rain in the forecast as well. The U.S. models as well as the European models, the 6 to 10 days still looking at some rains, and probably going to see some good coverage once again if we do end up getting that. Now, those models change day to day, but we didn't really talk about them today. And tomorrow morning, they're not going to matter once USDA comes out. But we're going to have talk about something else after this report. So we're going to shift the focus back onto weather. So continue looking at those weather maps as well. That still will be a primary focus once USDA releases these numbers tomorrow morning. So 7:30 tomorrow morning, these things come out. Reach us here at 800-262-7538. Otherwise, have a great day, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. See ya.